We're all Liberty Eagles. So before we begin with our pledges, I want our student council officers to please come to the front with me. Start with introducing our special guests. We have Mr. Castillon and Mr. Fraga that will be here. We also have our DARE officer, Officer Taralba. From Central Office, this is our communications director. We have Ms. Danny Byrne, that are coming from Eagle Pass High School, and one of these students was here where you all are at right now. We have Mia Martinez and David Piquelos. Also, guys, over here, standing in our corner, we have our law enforcement officers. We have Officer Cardenas, who's in charge of our Border Patrol liaison team. We have Officer Contreras, Officer Cabello, Officer Arellano, Officer Biggs, Officer Ford, and Officer Martinez. Okay. And so now we're going to go ahead and begin with our student council officers who will lead us in our U.S. Pledge, our Texas Pledge, our Liberty Eagle Pledge, and our National Anthem. So let's go ahead and stand so we can begin with our U.S. Pledge. Our U.S. Pledge is going to be said by our Vice President Tom Garcia and our Secretary Haley Rodriguez. Saying no to bullying, we're gonna have our JV cheerleader.
your life.
Read our Red Ribbon Pledge. As parents and citizens,
will talk to our children and the children in their life about the dangers of drug abuse. We will set clear rules for our children about not using drugs. We will set a good example for our children by not using illegal drugs or meds without prescription. We will monitor our children's behavior and enforce appropriate consequences so that our rules are respected. We will encourage family and friends to follow the same guidelines to keep children safe from substance abuse. Everyone with me, be drug-free.
That in order for us to live our dreams, we have to be drug free. Okay? So now we're going to have another performance by our cheerleaders.
Each and every one of you is that person. You all are going to help Deacon Camarena continue the tradition of being drug-free and helping this community out and the world out. We could stop this drug abuse. We could stop the medication abuse. We could also stop the bullying, because that's also affecting each and every one of us. But all of you here today have to take that pledge, have to continue with the honor of Deacon Camarena and saying no to drugs. There's going to be people out there you're going to meet in the future that are going to be offering you drugs, and your job is to say what?
No!
I can't hear you.
No!
Awesome, awesome. So all of you got to continue that. Just remember, it is day in every other prep rally we have for drug-free. Remember that Kika Camarena fought for you to have a drug-free world. So we got to fight for him to continue his tradition. Just like my sixth graders, like I tell them, each and each time I meet with them, it is your responsibility to say no to drugs, your responsibility to do the correct thing. And it goes for everybody in this school. We need to do the correct thing. And by doing that, it's saying no. And have fun the clean way, enjoy yourselves. This is for you, and this is for us to give that message. Thank you very much for having me today. Finally, Rick.
Now guys, we always bring in different guests so you can see how, if you want to be successful, if you want to do well, you have to continue being drug free. So we have Mr. Castillon today. Let me tell you a little bit about him. He graduated from Eagle Pass High School. He's the AT&T field manager, and on this side as his second job, he's a lead singer for a local band called Beam. But he's going to tell you, how was he able to make it there? Why did he get there? And what you can do to continue following your dreams the way Mr. Officer Toralba told you. Let's give him a big round of applause to Mr. Castillon.
Thank you, muchas gracias. I think I'm going to need
a microphone. All right, guys, as you said, I am the fuel manager for AT&T. I've been doing that for 12 years already. I cover 8 cities. I cover the technicians for 8 towns now. A while back, that was 16 cities that I used to be the manager for all the technicians in those cities. Then I had to promote one of my technicians, another friend of mine, also graduated from Eagle Pass High School, that he now takes care of the other 8 cities. But that's my day job. When I got hired, I was very excited, but before they said yes and I got the job, I had to do a drug test, like I'm sure a lot of our people here that have jobs have a drug test. I wouldn't have gotten this great job if I hadn't stayed drug-free. So I am very proud to be drug-free, like hopefully you guys are. A couple of days ago, as a matter of fact, like a week ago, I went through a training, and in the training, they were talking about the 9 of success. I don't know if some of you have already heard this before, but if you want to stay above the line of success, are you going to soar like an eagle or quack like a duck? Now, you guys are already eagles, so you're in the right path. You're already soaring like eagles. And what that's referring to is there's a formula called event time response equals outcome. You cannot control the event. And by event, I mean anything good or bad that happens to you. So if somebody offers you drugs, you can't control that.
No.
But you can control if you say yes or if you say no, right? So if you say yes, you're soaring like an eagle, guys. So thank you very much for that. You guys are eagles, and if you stay drug-free, you will always be soaring like eagles. On that note, also, I graduated from Eagle Pass High School. I was in the band. I know, I recognize one, a couple of you guys here that were in band with me. Your principal, Ms. Barcena, was in band with me, in case you guys didn't know that. Where is she? Is she here? So give it up for her also. But I continue with my music, and I use that to pay for my school. And now I have a band. My close friends and my family, they call me Pin, and that's what the name of the band is. And through the band, I've been able to meet a lot of great people, a lot of artists. And one of the great people that I met was Mr. Fraga. Some of you know Mr. Fraga. He's in 8 Eagle Pass ISD, retired now. And he plays for one of the best bands in Texas. but I called him yesterday and said, hey, can you help me out tomorrow? I'm gonna sing a couple of songs. I have a show on Wednesday, so I am a little bit, I don't have that much voice. I'm not gonna be able to hit the high notes. So I also brought another assistant with me, my sister, Karina, to help me out. Okay, we're gonna sing a couple of songs. I know some of you know, and I ask you guys to sing them with me if you know them, okay? You guys ready?
Baby, shake it, baby, baby, shake it, baby.
Yeah. And then Mr. Castillon, he's a parent. And Ms. Maldonado is a parent. And of course, Ms. Castillon in the back. And look at everything they're doing for you all to remind you guys what you need to do to be drug free. And they have a lot of important messages, such as soar like an eagle. Are you all going to soar like eagles?
Go around to all the schools and they promote the message of how to not be a bully through Impact Week, stay drug free, and they're role models to the younger students and their peers. And today I am delighted to introduce to y'all the EPISD Spirit Ambassadors from Eagle Pass High School, Ms. Mia Martinez and Mr. David Ipuroy.
Is that awesome?
Yeah!
Yes, wish them the best so they can bring home the trophy, right?
Hello guys, good morning. Awesome guys, I'm very happy to be here. Thank you all the parents, thank you teachers, thank you everyone here. I'm gonna take very, very little time. I got a couple things I wanna give away. So I need you to be quiet, I need you to sit down and listen to what I gotta say. So my name is Agent Gala, I'm from the Border Patrol. I'm not gonna talk about myself. I'll tell you what I do for a living. I got two jobs. So what I do for the Border Patrol. First job is make sure my partners, the dogs I work with, and myself get home. That's my job, make sure we get home. My second job, which is very important to me, is make sure you guys, everybody here, you sleep safe, you sleep comfortable, make sure that you're protected. When you guys go to bed, I'm working at night. Okay? When you guys are sleeping, I'm at night protecting the bad guys. All right, here it is, volunteers. How many here know what is the National Red Ribbon Team? 2018 National Red Ribbon Team. Ms. Aguilar, the student council president, she told you guys, and I think she was paying attention. Anybody know the National Red Ribbon Team 2018? Raise your hand. Who knows it? Right here, man. Come on down. Come over here. Every year we get a Red Ribbon Team for the week. The student of Ohio created it. Man, tell me what the theme is. Drug free. You're close. You're very close. Close, but not quite. Here it is. What's your name? A little louder.
My dad.
Thank you, man. My dad. Anybody know? Who knows it? Who knows the Red Ribbon Team? Right here, sir. Orange. Come on down. You gotta be quiet, right? You gotta be quiet. Anyway, listen. What's your name, sir? Julio. All right, Julio, you want to give a shout out to everybody? Shout out, all right. You want to give a shout out here? Here we go. Hold on. All right, Julio, what is the National Red Ribbon Team? You're here now. Tell us. Alright, you're there, good volunteer. Wait, we have someone here that knows the Red Ribbon Team? What's your name, sir? What's your name?
Bro.
Alright, bro, what's the National Red Ribbon Team?
Life is a journey.
Life is a journey, what else? Ding, 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 yes. Yeah, bro, awesome. Good job, bro. Like bro said, life is a journey, travel, drug free. Well, guess what, guys? Without getting up, without you moving, listen, without you getting up, without you moving, point to your favorite teacher. Everybody stop. Everybody stop. Now everybody point to me. Point to me. Awesome. Right? Now everybody hands down. Hands down. So as you see guys, there's teachers. Some of your favorite teachers. There's cops, principals, border patrol, customs, of course your parents. All of us guys care about you. And all of us have had a journey. And we have been drug free in our journey. Which means what? Your journey, again, raise your hand only, don't move. Some of your journey means how many of you play volleyball? How many of you play football? How many of you were cheerleaders? Okay? At this moment, your journey is that. All right, quiet. 1, 2, 3. Right now, your journey is a very small journey. There's people out here who we care. We want to see you succeed, your parents, coaches, teachers. So along those lines, we're not gonna let anybody bully you into doing drugs. Because we know we don't get bullied or we don't allow bullying, right? We know you guys say no to drugs. But I got a big surprise to you guys. If one of you doesn't listen to me and decides to do drugs, I got a couple of four-legged friends. I have very, 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 very strong love. One, two, three. Sit down. Crisscross applesauce. So, if you guys are quiet, I'm gonna give the microphone to a canine expert. Mr. Martinez knows everything about canines. Listen up, he's gonna tell you about dogs, and then we're gonna do some work for you guys with canines. Mr. Martinez.
This is the way it works. I have to toy the best way I can, like this. Do you guys see it? Tony sits down, he's like, man, my dad is amazing. Look at that. He made magic. That toy came out. So he's there, he's waiting. Then I throw the toy, he grabs it, and you guys know what happens next, right? I start doing the turkey call. Okay, I'm gonna bring out. I'm gonna bring Tony. Well, actually, I have this back. Yeah. I have containers right here. I'm gonna have Agent Cadenas come and help me real quick. We're gonna set the back containers, and I also have my colleagues, okay? Drugs. Let me set the drugs. There's certain rules we gotta follow, okay? First rule, I need everybody to remain seated, okay? Everybody remain seated. Do not get up. If you get up, the people behind you are not gonna be able to see it, okay? Second of all, y'all listening? What was the first rule? Remain seated, okay? Second rule. Because you guys are already doing it right now. I need for everybody to remain quiet, okay? Yes, because we never touch any drugs, correct? Yeah. Correct? Yeah. They always say no drugs, right? Yeah. Okay. He's gonna put those bags in that container right now. Now, Mr. Cadenas is gonna send the container. Are you sure that's going to be too easy? I'm going to find it real quick. Oh, yeah. Well, that'll start from back there. Okay. Okay, guys. Remember, stay seated. Remain quiet. If you guys want to help me out, you guys want to help me out? Yeah. Okay. When Ricky finds the drug, he's gonna get the toy. Remember what we're gonna do? Yeah. The turkey call? Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's bring Agent Ford and pay that Ricky down. Now we're gonna go. Okay, guys, remain quiet. Here it comes. One of our youngest dogs that we have working in the Border Patrol. He's been working in the Border Patrol for a year. He's right there. Remember to stay quiet. Now the toy comes out. He takes the toy inside that box. So here comes the toy. He's waiting. Thank you.
right, guys, if you got another surprise, and I got another little thing here, so we're just quiet and sitting down. Not only are you going to get a lanyard, you're going to get to choose where you want to put the box, okay? So, man, you want to give me a volunteer? Because I know you can check the AMK and who's behaving, who's not. All right, guys, while she does that, remember, guys, if you ever get bullied, if somebody ever tries to or forces to get drunk or touch drugs, make sure you tell somebody. Whatever you do, you tell someone, your dad, your mom, tell a teacher, tell a coach, make sure you tell somebody. Because we do not let anyone scare us or bully us into doing drugs. All right, so come on down, sir. What's your name?
Ami.
A little louder.
Ami.
Me? Okay, sir. You get to choose. Well, first of all, you get in your lanyard because you're going to say no drugs. And you get to choose where do you want to place the little box. One, two, three, or four. We already did number one, so you get to choose where you want to put it. You can grab it. Look, that's the one that has the drugs. Grab that one, sir. What do you want it? One, two, three, or four. Number two? You sure? Okay. There we go. Here comes Tony. You can put it down. Put it down there. Thank you. Here comes Tony. You can go sit down, Nico. Sit down. Thank you so much. All right, I see Tony's ready. Sir, can you give me Tony, please? All right, nobody tell Tony where it's at. Nobody say it. It's box number two. Nobody say it. Knock it, knock it. All right, we gotta be quiet. We gotta be quiet. Quiet, quiet, quiet. One, two. I'm gonna let you get loud when the dog gets his reward. When the dog gets his reward, you have to get as loud as you want, okay? We got a deal. Ready. Is it there? The famous little tail. Well, we got more surprises, we got more dogs. You guys just give a big hand. A big hand. I'm going to give the microphone to another canine expert and there'll be more surprises, but I need, again, we need to be quiet and we need to sit down.
Thank you, Joey. All right, this bag has I think they're apples or mangoes or something. It's not good though. All right, we're gonna bring Sable. By the way, Sable's about 355 years old in dog years, and the handler is 55. They've been working together for about 90 years. They're outstanding together. You think she's gonna find it? Come on, Sable. Don't make me look bad here. Don't let me down. Is that the bag? Outstanding. Good job. Good job. All right. She gets paid with sausage. Something like that. Right? With pepperoni. Who likes pepperoni? I love pepperoni. Well, Sable likes pepperoni. All right.
Mr. Officer Joe Cabello, by the way, is the father of Joey and Annette, by the way. Alright, Mr. Cabello here, he's got Shadow, that's her name. She's about 95 years old. She's about 97,000 years old in Buck years. I'm working together for about 57 years. And alright, listen. We're pretending we're coming from Mexico, and these people here are bringing stuff from Mexico. Bad drugs. We know drugs are bad, right? One of these empty drugs? Outstanding, I love it. Alright, one of these people is pretending to bring something from Mexico. And Shadow is gonna fight it. She's gonna sit, she's gonna get paid with a toy, and we're all gonna be happy forever after. Kinda. Except the person with the drugs. Okay. Is that the right person? Alright, outstanding. Give her a hand, boys and girls. Give her a hand. Outstanding. All right, boys and girls, that's pretty much our presentation. We love to be here. We're happy to be here. You can call us back anytime you want. Hey, for the adults, listen, really quick. And you have to be quiet for a minute. Alright, for the adults, we do not give drugs to our dogs. They do not consume, they don't eat, they don't do anything with drugs. They are drug free. We don't give them drugs to find drugs. All they work for is that little toy you saw. Because they don't do drugs, just like all of you, right? Outstanding. Thank you for having us. Call us back anytime.
Are we all going to do that? Yeah. Okay, so to end,